Hello everyone, welcome to Semiconductor. Today, I'd like to talk about wire bonding process. Wire bonding process is to connect die and package substrate with wire. It makes bridges for data from die to electronic product and it makes operate. Gold ball bonding is the most popular way in wire bonding, and it makes ball shape at the end of wire. There are three major steps in ball bonding. First step is to make bond a die bond pad. During first step, we need to make ball shape at the end of wire, and it is made by electrical spark called electronic play mob, in short EFO. Also, this ball shape part is called free air ball, in short FAB. Wire with free air ball is moving down to die bond pad, then form ball bond by using ultrasonic energy and heat energy. Second step is to make wire loop from die. During second step, we need to make loop height we design, and reverse distance to make loop stable mechanically, not to collapse. Third step is to make bond as substrate bond pad. During third step, we need to make wedge bond at the end of wire, looks like wedge. It is also called stitch bond. Ultrasonic energy and heat energy are used to make wedge bond. After bonding, we need to cut wire to complete wire bonding process. Another wire bonding method is wedge bonding. It makes wedge shape bond at die pad and substrate bond pad. So, there is no ball shape bond. For this reason, it uses wedge bonding machine and wedge bonding tool, which is different with capillary for ball bonding. Wedge bonding is popular for aluminum wire bonding. There are other wire materials, for example, copper, silver, and aluminum. Copper wire is used to reduce cost because gold wire is expensive, but it requires more ultrasonic energy and bonding pores with a special kit to prevent oxidation because of its material properties, hard and very easy to react with oxygen. More ultrasonic energy and bonding pores will have a higher risk to damage die and wire, which is not good. Silver wire is also used to reduce cost, lower than gold. But if copper cannot be used because die pad is sensitive and can be damaged by high bonding pores for copper. Silver wire is also used for LED device thanks to its better reflectivity. Aluminum wire is used wherever low process temperature is necessary, and in use wedge bonding. Especially thick aluminum wire more than 100 micrometer diameters are used for high current application, for example, power component. In summary, there are two major wire bonding methods. One is ball bonding and the other one is wedge bonding. There are four major wire bonding materials. Gold is the most popular. Copper is getting popular thanks to its low cost, but it is hard and easy to oxidize material, and special care is required. Silver is good for sensitive die pad devices and LED devices, with lower cost than gold. Aluminum is good for high current carrying application with thick diameters. Now, you have some idea about wire bonding process. Have a nice day and see you again soon. Bye-bye.